had to make myself keep thinking about just right outside. Pretty much like no matter what I feel. Wait.
Yeah, now sit back with your shoulders. Good. Very good.
Okay.
All right. Much better. That's the way it's got to be every time. Good.
Good. Oh, that's okay. I like it, Ashley. Just watch your hands and your heels. Hands a little bit more forward, heels down. But I love the reaction you got. That was great.
Get it down. Come on.
Yeah.
Good for you. Very good. I want to see both of them one more time. Front of the shoulders. Yeah. All right. Good, Ashley. He can walk and take a break. Super. All right. Excellent, Michaeline. Fair set. It's like at the drop of a hat, you suddenly tiny pony. Kick it.
Come on. Get up.
Good. I want to see it one more time. Finding that deep distance as well, and you understand mechanically how to make that happen. Keep the same canter, think square. Yeah, good for you. And I want you to canter down and do it one more time, because he had been moving up to a gappy distance, he went to do the same thing again, didn't he? You made the right correction, that was good. This is for him, not for you. Square off the turn and find that deep distance again. That's okay. Yep, super. Good job. So that's just where it's important when we're finding the gappy distances that you don't fall into the trap of moving up to them. If you've got to move up to them, then you should be waiting and just letting them do a chip strike. If you're coming to a gappy distance, just let the gappy distance happen within the same canter and don't move up to it so they don't fall into that trap.
Okay.
Okay, Molly. Jump in the same way, but once you're in, I want you to make that whole grid line take a second or 2 seconds longer by slowing the canter down in between the jumps more. And it may mean that you need to use your arm a little bit in the half halt in between the fences. Change the canter, jump in, get it. Jump in and then slow down. Now slow down.